All right, welcome everyone. Recently, one of my subscribers left a comment on my Nightwatch page object model video that he'd like to see a complete example of configuring Nightwatch and SauceLabs for automated testing. I thought that would make a great video tutorial because while Nightwatch offers cloud testing support in SauceLabs and Browser Stack, it took me a bit of digging to find out how. So today, we'll be learning how to use SauceLabs with Nightwatch.js. And in a Nightwatch test using SauceLabs, the test is executed locally, but the actual browser and interactions are done in the SauceLabs cloud. Your local Nightwatch test sends the commands to the remote browser at SauceLabs, which executes the work and sends back the results. Now for me, the hardest part was figuring out how and where to capture and upload the test results to complete the loop with SauceLabs when the test completed, but I made that into an NPM package we'll be talking about a little bit later. To follow along, you can grab the source code for this example on github.com/reallymellow in the Nightwatch Tutorials project. Okay, so now we're here at my GitHub page under Nightwatch Tutorials. In today's tutorial example, we're going to be working out of the SauceLabs example folder. So let's go ahead and clone this repository. All right, so now that we have that cloned, let's head into the Nightwatch Tutorials folder and then open up our SauceLabs example. All right, now that we're here, we can run npm install to bring in all of our package dependencies. All right, so now we have all of our packages. Let's open up our IDE of choice. I'm going to use brackets. So let's take a look here at the Nightwatch project structure itself. So here we have our SauceLabs example. I have my page objects stored under page objects. The test is under test, and then our various configuration files are down below. I'm not going to go extensively into page objects because I cover that in my other tutorials. Okay, so let's start off here with the package JSON file. So the packages that make this work are obviously the Nightwatch framework itself, this nightwatch-saucelabs-endsauce package, which is the NPM package that I created for uploading the results back to SauceLabs, and then this is the SauceLabs REST package right here that does all of the communications work between Nightwatch and SauceLabs itself. And these all get brought in when you do NPM install. And then all the wiring gets done in nightwatch.json, so let's open that up next. To make sure that Nightwatch finds the nightwatch-saucelabs-endsauce package in your custom commands path, you need to make a reference to the node modules nightwatch-saucelabs-endsauce commands directory, just like I have it here, so that it will find the library when it runs. If you're using page objects like we are in this example, you'll need to specify the directory of your page objects folder, like we have here. So one of the great features of Nightwatch.js is that it has the ability to run your tests in parallel. And to do that, you simply use this test worker section here and set this enabled flag equal to true. And you can set your worker count here to auto or a fixed number, and you can configure that how you want. And now what makes that interesting in SauceLabs is that if you've purchased a large VM allocation and you want to use it all, you can set it to auto and it will expand out to one session per JavaScript test class that you have inside of your project. So if you structure your Nightwatch test project in such a way where maybe you have something like 10 JS files, they can all run in parallel against the SauceLabs cloud. So now let's go further here into test settings. You need to specify your Selenium port, which in most cases should be 443, which is the SSL default. And then your Selenium host, again, in most cases for SauceLabs, should be ondemand.saucelabs.com. You'll want to, of course, use SSL. And now down in this section, you'll want to fill in your username, access key, and sauce region that ties back to your SauceLabs account. Here I'm using environment variables, which is better than checking in your username and access key into your source repository. Your account may also be tied to a region, so you can specify that under the sauce region variable. And now down here under desired capabilities is where you would tell SauceLabs what sort of browser configuration you want to run your tests under. So here's your browser name. So here I want my tests running under Chrome. And if you want to specify the screen resolution that your tests run under, you would specify that here. Here I'm using 1280 by 1024. You can specify a specific browser version, which is handy if you're trying to do maybe one back testing. You can enable JavaScript, accept SSL certificates, and set your time zone. I found this was very important to do this. Otherwise, I was getting some very odd date behavior on some of my web pages that had some JavaScript dates on it. Because I'm under the Eastern time zone, my actual test region is on the West Coast, and I don't know what was happening, but once I synced it up with the time zone that my runner was under, everything was fine. So that's an interesting gotcha that I found. So that's all the configuration that you need to do to get your Nightwatch test working under SauceLabs. All right, so let's take a closer look at this sauce-labs-test.js. So pretty simple test, it's just testing my homepage, but let's start off here taking a look at the test hooks. We have a before each test hook and an after each test hook. And what these do is they run before and after each one of these actual test cases. And the pattern I was used to that I felt was more efficient, especially when you're trying to get to functionality that's buried behind a login page and various other navigation that you have to do, would be that I would like log in, navigate to the area under test, and then kind of stay there for the remainder of that test suite. And I would write the tests where they were sort of like encapsulated so that one wasn't dependent on the other, just that they were dependent on being in a particular area of the web page. So I would handle that in the before hook and not before each. And then I would only close the browser in the after so that I would only close it down when I was done with everything. But SauceLabs doesn't like that. It's heavily dependent on the browser session in order to break up the individual test cases. So you actually have to close the browser fully in between each test so that you get a new browser session. And if you don't do that, what you'll notice is all the tests in your test class get lumped into one giant test. So you lose the resolution and like fine detail of what passes and fails in between. So this is the better pattern. It's a little bit slower, but if you're threading out your tests, like I was mentioning earlier, it's a give and take where things might actually end up being more efficient under SauceLabs anyway. But that's just a nuance here that you have to deal with. So to make all that magic happen, we're doing that again in the after each block. So the first thing you have to do, like I mentioned, is you have to close the browser. So we're calling browser.end to do that. And now we're calling browser.endsauce. Now, endsauce is that package that we brought in earlier that I was talking about, nightwatch-saucelabs-endsauce. And you can get that off of npm, or like I said, it just comes in when you do an npm install on this tutorial project. All that package is doing is closing the loop with SauceLabs and uploading the pass or failed status and giving it the name of the test that passed and failed so that when you look at your SauceLabs output, it makes sense. And for context, let's just go ahead and talk through what the tests are doing. These again are simple tests because the purpose of this tutorial is just to make sure that the SauceLabs communication with Nightwatch is working correctly. So the first thing I do is I go to my homepage and assert that the title is David Mello. And then I verify that I can navigate to the software testing portion of the website by clicking on the software testing link at the top. And then I verify that once I land there that the correct title displays. And lastly, there's some functionality on the web page that changes the theming based on the icon that you click. And I want to make sure that it changes the background color correctly when I'm toggling that button. So let's just walk through that a little bit here. So here we are on my web page. And again, it just verifies that the title is David Mello. And then when you click on the software testing link there, that it has software testing and quality assurance on this top banner. And that last test, it just toggles between this little moon and sun to make sure that the theming of the color scheme changes and updates correctly. So now that we talked through all of that, let's execute the test now. So in a terminal window in the SauceLabs example directory, let's type out Nightwatch and hit enter. And you should see it connecting to ondemand.saucelabs.com on port 443 or whatever you specified. And you can see that Nightwatch is running your tests just like it would a local test. And down here at the bottom, this is the output from the endsauce package. It shows you your session ID and the job name, which is equal to your test case, and then the passed or failed status. And you get the same test output in your terminal window that you would a local Nightwatch test, but SauceLabs is sending that output back from their cloud into your terminal. So I can see that all my assertions passed. So that's good news. My webpage is working. Let's head over now to the SauceLabs webpage and see what was recorded. All right, so now we're in the SauceLabs webpage looking at the automated test results log. So one of the nice things I added to that Nightwatch SauceLabs endsauce NPM package I was referring to is that if you have your tests nicely organized and stored into folders like this one is, it will add as a prefix the name of the folder. So I had it stored in the blog folder and then it adds a dash and then the name of the test. For me, I found that very helpful because when these tests are running in parallel and I'm looking at the output of the test results here in SauceLabs, it doesn't always come in a predictable order. So this kind of helps me keep track of what a test is doing because you might have similarly named tests, and this way you can kind of more easily see what area of the product that the test is testing. So now let's drill in here and show off some of the cool features that you get out of SauceLabs when this is wired up correctly. So my favorite part so far of SauceLabs has been this video output. It's tremendously valuable on seeing what's actually happening as the test is running, not on your local machine, right? So let's play the video. So this is the test that changes the theming on the web page by clicking on this sun and moon icon. So you'll see the background changing. So my second favorite feature that SauceLabs provides is this commands output. And these are all time-coded commands. So if you have a very long running video, you can just skip directly to the portion that you're interested in. So if I wanted to see what happened after I clicked on this button, and watch the output, I can. Right in the video, I don't need to watch minutes of video to see what happened. And when you expand these little triangles, you can see what Nightwatch sent over the wire to SauceLabs and what they received. So this is also very good for debugging. All right, so that's how to use SauceLabs with Nightwatch.js. If you have any questions at all, let me know in the comment section down below. And also let me know if you found this useful. I'd love to hear from you. Let me know if you have any other ideas for future tutorials. Consider subscribing to my channel if you'd like to see more of this kind of content. And thanks for watching.